Ignore opinion polls. Opinion polls are a mzungu thing imported from the US. People are trying very hard to plant them into Kenyan politics, which can't work because Kenyan voters vote as blocks. They vote tribally. So whatever sample analysis you do to make your opinion poll will never make sense. Okay? And I've just given the example in the video I've made for the public on YouTube, how Kalonzo Musyoka led most of the opinion polls in the run-up to 2007. Until it got into his head, he believed he has support. But actually, he didn't. Because it's very simple. Just take, even if you don't have the voter registration figures, I'm just talking about the Kalonzo Musyoka case. If you don't have voter registration figures, just look at the profile population of Kenyans and try and pinpoint the ones most likely to vote for Kalonzo Musyoka and get their numbers, even their rough numbers. And you'll see that those opinion polls must have been totally rubbish. Okay? And on to what I wanted to cover today. The president is in a very difficult position. For the last 4 years, he has been ruling like a co-president with one William Ruto. A lot of the decisions they have made have been instigated by William Ruto. I think this is a fact many people know, but I guess not everybody knows. William Ruto is probably one of the most powerful deputy presidents the country has ever had. And because of this, William Ruto cannot just be brushed away suddenly. And you cannot, even you listening to this, cannot afford to get bored of the discussion about one William Ruto. Because whether I like it, whether you like it or not, and whether I like it or not, this man will have an impact on those August elections. So we have to pay close attention to what he's doing, close attention to his moves. We have to analyze him if we're going to get this thing accurate and know exactly what's going to happen in August 2017. Okay? So the president is in a difficult position because for the first time since he took power, he does not have Ruto. He probably has other people. Like I'm told, one of his closest advisors right now is none other than his mother, who actually is fairly qualified because she has a lot of experience from the days of Jomo in running government. And as we are told, there's no substitute to experience. Okay? But the bottom line is that the president is no longer with Ruto. Number two, Ruto has over the years when he has been co-president, over these last 4 years, built a lot of support in various parts of the country, in government institutions. He has his own people. If I can give you just one example which comes straight out of my mind, the Inspector General of Police, Bwana Boynet, is a Ruto man. The man owes his career to Ruto. Ruto pushed through his name. Ruto pushed through his quick acceptance by the Parliamentary Select Committee, to which vets appointments by the president. Ruto did everything for him. And that is why during the recent problem in the Rift Valley, when the DP, William Ruto, was there, the police inspector general was always there, taking instruction, taking notes, and acting. Okay? So, the problem here that the president has is that even if, assuming that, because we already know that Ruto's people are going around the country blaming Jubilee, pointing fingers at the president, saying, oh, unless you do this, we're getting problems, getting support for you, blah, blah, blah. You've read it in the media. This dance, which is being done by Ruto people, definitely a lot of people think it's going to affect the president. My personal view is that the damage will be limited at most, and I'll tell you why. Let's assume worst case scenario. Ruto decides I will not back, I'm withdrawing from being the president's running mate, and I will not back Jubilee for the next general elections. What do you think will happen? That all the Kalenjin votes will go where Ruto goes? No, I don't think so. Ruto has got his supporters. Gideon Moi has got his supporters. There could be few, but they're enough to cause the whole Kalenjin nation to rethink. So no matter how much William Ruto is loved, William Ruto outside Jubilee is less powerful than William Ruto, as far as votes are concerned, is less powerful than William Ruto within Jubilee. But then, let's grant it, his wings have been clipped recently because Jubilee has married a second wife, covering the same Kalenjin nation in Gideon Moi. And of course, this is making Ruto and his handlers very uncomfortable, because obviously, you've given me a job to do, you trust me as your right-hand man, and then you bring in somebody else to do exactly the job I'm supposed to do. What am I supposed to think? As the Waswahili say, akufukuzae, akuambi inenda. So that is a predicament. But I think that if the worst happens to the worst, and the DP leaves Jubilee and decides not to be running mate to the president anymore, Jubilee can still get plenty of votes from the Rift Valley. And if Gideon Moi is intelligent enough to prove to them that Jubilee is going to win re-election, then they will also get the votes which William Ruto has. So really, that is something which is important, which you should all bear in mind. I trust that you also received the special report I did on Ruto's family life. I believe somebody's family life really affects what they do politically. It affects your concentration, it affects your intuition, it affects everything. So this is relevant. Even if some of us might have felt that's a bit too much gutter press. But even if you feel like that, these are things which affect the election. I don't try to include things which I don't think will affect these elections. I think that will affect these elections in that the Ruto will be out there, will be a Ruto with serious marital problems. And therefore it affects the way the guy functions. It affects his emotions, affects his psyche. It affects everything, virtually. So that is what the state of affairs is. I have been talking to insiders on the Ruto side, and the feeling I get is that the strategy of the DP will be to stay put. Now that has massive repercussions because, for instance, what's going to happen with the Baringo senatorial business, senatorial seat business? Because we know that one of the deals that Jubilee has done with KANU is that they'll not field a candidate in Baringo. But we have heard from Ruto's handlers time and time again that they have a very strong candidate for Baringo. And they're sure that the candidate is going to win and remove Gideon Moi from his senatorial seat. So you understand how complicated that is. Because now, as you go into the primaries, how will they handle that? That is one of the difficulties. But the situation is still the same. In my personal, if I can just call them opinion polls in quotes, the president is still leading. The opposition have gained support, but most of this support they have gained is from non-Jubilee areas. I think that is so important, I need to repeat. It is true the opposition has gained some support, but the support they have gained is from non-Jubilee strongholds. Bar one, Meru. That is an exception. And, you know, we cannot write off the whole election because of one area. Yes, Meru votes are sizable, but I don't think we can begin to make long-drawn conclusions from this issue. It's just a matter of waiting to see how things develop and how we can go forward from there. Others, I hope to be doing, I'm trusting to be doing these recordings more frequently to give you the information more frequently. Even daily, so that we can be able to have a very good update of what's going on, what's up, what is happening in the news, and so that we're able to analyze properly, especially now as we go into a very crucial part of the next general election, which is the primaries within the parties. I think it's very crucial that we know exactly what's going on, what each side is doing, and I need to repeat again that it is very important that you come to this, you leave your heart, and you leave your heart and watch a royako, and even the party which you support, leave it outside these commentaries. Because if you carry them, it will cloud your judgment, you will not be able to listen to what is happening, because you will say, oh, Chris is against Jubilee, or oh, Chris is against NASA. Chris just says things that attack NASA all the time, you know, that kind of thing. You will not be able to have a good, solid understanding of what is happening politically. I guess that's it for now. I'm sure we will do another recording very soon to be able to analyze some of the situations as they unfold. But I think just to sum it up, right now, DP Ruto has decided to stay put. That is also dangerous because we don't know what his next move will be. But we don't. It's the impact this Ruto issue is going to have on Jubilee is going to be minimal at best, because it does not affect, for example, their strongholds in areas like Central Province. It doesn't affect that. Whatever he says, whatever he tries to say, whatever image he tries to portray. Okay. So thank you very much. Until next time.